During a recent test over the Nevada Test and Training Range, an F-22 Raptor pilot successfully assumed in-flight control of an MQ-20 Avenger combat drone, marking a major milestone in the Air Force's emerging robotic wingman program. The demonstration showed something long theorized but never executed in such an integrated way. This milestone signals a shift toward a new style of air combat built around human-machine teaming, distributed formations, and rapidly upgradeable open architecture systems. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why F-22 Raptor controlling MQ-20 Avenger is a significant development. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The test showed that an operational F-22 Raptor could directly command an MQ-20 Avenger drone while both aircraft were in flight. Using a tablet-based pilot vehicle interface integrated into the F-22's cockpit systems, the pilot issued mission-level instructions to the drone, altering its flight behavior and tasking it to perform coordinated actions. This interaction did not rely on a ground control station or an additional operator. Instead, the fighter pilot executed these commands in real time as part of the aircraft's normal mission workflow. A key achievement of the demonstration was the successful integration of systems from multiple companies into a single, seamless command chain. The event was the result of a collaborative effort involving General Atomics, Lockheed Martin, and L3 Harris, who combined their systems to enable seamless communication and tasking between the two aircraft. The fighter's interface, the open architecture radios, and the drone's onboard autonomy software all work together, showing that dissimilar and independently developed technologies can interoperate without friction. This compatibility is crucial for the U.S. Air Force's vision of a highly modular, multi-platform combat ecosystem where crewed fighters and autonomous aircraft share tasks across a distributed battle space. General Atomics described the event as the newest in a series of internally funded demonstrations designed to highlight what is now achievable in manned-unmanned teaming. The test combined L3 Harris's data links and software-defined radios with Lockheed Martin's open radio architecture, allowing the aircraft to operate through non-proprietary, government-owned communication networks. According to C. Mark Brinkley, a spokesperson for General Atomics, this is believed to be the first time an F-22 has directly commanded an autonomous combat drone in flight. Brinkley said, "General Atomics is in a pretty unique situation here, given that we already have operational uncrewed jets to use for experimentation. The MQ-20 Avenger, tricked out with mature mission autonomy software, is a perfect CCA surrogate and allows us to move fast and move first." Viewers may note in this context that the U.S. Air Force's Collaborative Combat Aircraft, CCA, program is a cornerstone of its next-generation air dominance strategy. Rather than depending entirely on costly, crewed fighters like the F-22, F-35, or the future NGAD platform, the U.S. Air Force plans to deploy swarms of affordable, adaptable drones to fly alongside them. These drones will expand sensor reach, add extra firepower, and handle high-risk missions without endangering pilots. General Atomics is trying to win the U.S. Air Force's ongoing collaborative combat aircraft competition and is competing against defense company Anduril. The first increment production design contract is to be awarded in 2026. Following General Atomics' announcement, Lockheed Martin's Skunk Works division stated that it had led and coordinated the overall demonstration. OJ Sanchez, Skunk Works' vice president and general manager, said in a statement, "This effort represents Skunk Works bringing its diverse and unique expertise to the table to lead the way demonstrating the future of air combat, where single-seat aircraft command and control drones with simple and intuitive interfaces in the cockpit." The ability of an F-22 to control an MQ-20 Avenger marks a major transition in how the U.S. Air Force envisions air combat. By pairing a fifth-generation fighter with an autonomous jet-powered wingman, the demonstration proved that crewed aircraft can expand their combat reach and battlefield awareness without adding more pilots to the fight. This directly supports the emerging family of systems concept, in which a single fighter serves as the central node for distributed formation of uncrewed assets, each carrying out sensing, jamming, or strike tasks. What makes this especially important is that the test was conducted using a single-seat aircraft, showing that high-workload cockpits can still support advanced human-machine teaming without overloading the pilot. Another reason this milestone matters is the successful use of open architecture communications and software-defined radios, which allowed the F-22 and MQ-20 to share data and commands despite coming from different vendors. This demonstrates a shift away from closed proprietary systems toward plug-and-play military networks that can adapt more quickly to new threats and technologies. It also means that legacy platforms like the F-22 can be upgraded to take on new roles, such as acting as airborne mission commanders for autonomous systems, greatly extending the operational relevance of older but still highly capable aircraft. The stakes are very high. The U.S. Air Force's new 10-year fighter roadmap, released last month, underscored the service's commitment to fielding collaborative combat aircraft alongside the F-22. The 24-page strategy identified drone wingmen as essential for operating in highly contested environments and emphasized that modernizing the F-22 is a top priority largely because of its role as the first platform to integrate with CCAs. According to the document, the F-22 will serve as the baseline aircraft for early CCA operations, with the uncrewed systems eventually supporting the next generation F-47 fighter in meeting the demands of future high-threat missions. Production of the F-47 is already underway, with its first flight targeted for 2028. So the F-22's in-flight control of the MQ-20 Avenger is far more than a tech demo. It is a decisive proof that fifth-generation fighters can operate as command hubs for autonomous combat air vehicles. This fundamentally changes how air dominance can be achieved. It multiplies combat power, enhances survivability, and pushes air warfare toward a distributed human-machine team future, one where a single fighter pilot may command an entire formation of intelligent, mission-capable, unmanned wingmen. So it can be said that this test is a precursor to many things to come.